Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrving.
For the trials, like when we first
I'll
met,
find
remember?
Him. What's that? Did you hear that?
Nothing.
Was that voices?
Is that his voice or the voice of the dead?
Not Dillian.
Dillian's calling to you. Can you hear him?
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires, as though they were mist.
I can hear him.
Within the burial mound, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword. She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning. You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead. Like I said, she reminds me of you.
I told you it was a trick.
What's happening? It's not him, it can't be.
It's the sound, the voice is changing.
What? That's not Dillian.
That doesn't sound.
Hervor ignores her father's warnings. The grave mound opens, and it seems to be full of fire. Again, Hervor demands her inheritance. But her father warns her that the sword is cursed and would be the bane of her family. But he relents and brings her the sword. She leaves the island with it, but the curse holds true, and death would follow in the years to come. And so, said the mother, the misdeeds of a father have cursed his daughter.
It's not Dillian. wants me to face my fears. Father? I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief had some.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you.
No.
They will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come.
I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur, the second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die. This story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood.
He's close.
loves you.
Seems so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
Mother, is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe? I did not ask the mistletoe, Baldur's mother confesses. I thought it was too young. Oh dear.
Your curse has claimed Dillian.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hood, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hood says, I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon.
Loki has it passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend. Dillian. She saw things no one else could. Patterns. Shapes. Movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go. And she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past. And Dillian, a future. Two realities tearing at her soul.
She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief. And she... Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur. Weep him out of hell. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees.
Do you know? Was it worth it?
You're still alive and Dillian's dead. He doesn't deserve to be dead.
How does that make you feel?
Nobody will love her now.
Can you remember what love feels like?
Look what happens to the thing she loves.
She destroys the thing she loves.
Wasting your time.
You have no time for this. Speedy.
These rooms mean nothing. It's all part of their game.
You
set
your trials to distract you.
Set you up. And they're going to watch you for it.
Runes, you see runes everywhere.
Everywhere?
But what if they're not real?
What if they don't actually make sense?
What if they're a trick?
The gods were lying.
If you think it makes sense, but really the gods are playing with you.
It makes sense in your mind, but it doesn't make sense in the real
world.
The gods are playing.
But it doesn't mean anything.
You can't read this language, you don't understand.
Simba was right.
You're wasting time.
You're cursed.
Succeed. What if they're all about wasting your time, just delay you minute by minute? What does she think she's doing? You're special.
She thinks she can
play you. No. Special.
Waste of time.
Could all be a waste of her time.
The gods are just
playing.
What if the gods are lying?
Dillian! For the first time. There he is.
Dillian never much cared for the underworld and looked dimly upon the druids like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see, and he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, and to see the world through his eyes. And slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
You're going to fall, Kev.
No, she's not. She's not going to fall. She's strong. She's steady. She can do it. You can do it, Simba.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. Should we fix them by taking away their sight? Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay?
What if this is
gift? You have?
What if you're wrong?
What if this has nothing to do with the sword?
What if we're wrong?
The sword will...
The gift that makes you so special in my life.
What if this is
just
the end?
It's just a trick.
Now.
It's just a pointless test.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
I need to follow the wilds to protect you.
It's just their game for you.
You never know which way it's going to go.
Because I know. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
Say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Where am I? I can't see. Who's there?
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from. The others.
Yes, you can.
The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
I can't go on. Dillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
I think I'm somewhere else now. But the breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to.
I've reached the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
So sorry. I thought I left this all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father. He taught me that the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the soul. You're no coward.
proved that for me in the Warrior Trials. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need people like you.
Okay. I'll do my best. There's a waterfall. I can't go on this way.
Then look for another way.
There is a house. I don't know what's inside.
Don't be afraid.
Not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forwards.
There is more of them. I think they're moving.
You're breathing too fast.
I'm scared.
Listen to the sound of your breath. In and out. In and out. Do this anyway.
I think I'm in a house. It stinks of death.
The darkness is testing you, but you are in control.
as well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself, in the dark.
You see me?
Yes.
Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere. With no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
But I heard your voice. You brought me back.
You found your own way back. All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it.
This place feels... What is this place?
This place feels... It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
There he is. There he is.
The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
He's going in.
He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
We know he's gone.
Keep going.
Like the old warrior trials. Dillian will help me.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? No. Don't worry. Not everyone can. a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. To the water. She could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong. Something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like them.
The Northmen speak of a death moon. A light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm. And first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhand, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. But that is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death moon, then beware. Because there will be death in that house.
She did it. She
did it. You fixed the bridge.
She fixed it.
You passed the trial, got the house.
You succeeded.
Come to me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there?
There was a Northman called Gretti. Big, red-haired, immensely strong. But he was afraid of the dark. It happened one night that an undead creature came.
Dillian! They're coming for me!
It's close, move away.
Senua! Senua! What happened?
blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. It doesn't make them true.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I have. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.